walked for what seemed like a thousand years into the depths of the wilderness, the darkest parts of the unknown, through concrete jungles of my inner sleep, to the deepest secrets inside of me. Slowly I found my way. I've been looking for so long for a place to call my own, not knowing the whole time that the search begins inside. Knowing is half the journey, and faith provides the rest. And I'm blessed to know that when I'm happy, I'm home. There's no rushing lifelong dreams to see, no race to the end to begin again. It takes time to find the path inside, to speak with your heart and liberate your mind. Slowly I found my way. I've been looking for so long for a place to call my own, not knowing the whole time that the search begins inside. Knowing is half the journey, and faith provides the rest. And I'm blessed to know that when I'm happy, I'm home. When I'm happy, I'm home. I'm happy, I'm home. When I'm happy, I'm home. When I'm happy, I'm home. Like a koala stays in the same tree his whole life, I give in to the game and let my soul fly, to be a constant creator and seeker of divine. I give in to the eternal sands of time. I surrender and let go to the endless road. I surrender and let go to the endless road. I surrender and let go. When I'm happy, when I'm happy, I'm home. 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 When I'm happy, I'm home.
Thank you all so much for sharing in that with me. Really grateful you are all here to rock and recode tonight. That's what we do. And I see some new faces out there, which always makes me very excited to introduce people to this amazing, profound work that has really changed my life in so many ways. And yeah, I wanted to share a little bit about what Superconscious Recode really is, and the foundation of what this whole work is getting into this thing that we're not so used to being in our culture, which is a creative structure, right? A creative structure is a structure we can be in where we're focusing on that end result, right? We've made a choice, there's that end result, and we keep creating towards that choice. And what our culture at large is more used to is problem-solving structure, right? So there's a problem and we have to fix it is basically what that means. And so a lot of the times, instead of just going for it, right, we want to fix what's wrong with us. We think there's something wrong with us and we want to fix that, or we want to heal that, and then we'll go and do the thing we want to do, right? So we're kind of often living backwards in that way, right? And this is one extreme, right, where everything kind of has to be perfect. I have to be perfect before I even start, right? Everything just has to be in place. My life has to be together. I've had to have worked through all of my challenges, all of my issues, all of my unconscious beliefs, right? I got to work through them all and then I'll go create. And so often that stops us dead in our tracks. And what we don't realize, and what I love about this super conscious work, it says, no, you actually don't have to fix anything. And really, the thing that's making you want to fix something in the first place is this resistance that's coming up. There's a resistance happening. And this is something that, a lot of the new age law of attraction stuff doesn't always take into account, right? It's like you make the choice, you visualize it or whatever, and then you go towards it, right? What it's not taking into account is that for a lot of people, there is a resistance too. And so, yes, one of the secrets is you can make a choice, you can visualize it, you can be it, right, to see it in your life, which is also what this work is about. And there's like another secret that you may be bumping up into resistance, and superconscious recode is the way to let go of that resistance. So instead of avoiding it, or one there's two extremes. There's like completely avoiding it, right? And trying to take the action but not realizing there's this resistance in the way, and you wonder why you can't get there. Like you keep getting stopped and you keep running into bumps in the road and you just can't get past it, right? And then there's this other side, which is like I was saying a little earlier, is that we want to try to fix and heal everything that we believe is wrong with ourselves before we go for it. And so this creative structure says, okay, like I'm gonna make a true choice. And what a true choice is something that's really a heart calling, right? Like one of your heart's greatest desires, and it can be in any area of your life. We have it across all areas usually of like what our heart's greatest desire is. And when it comes from the heart, and when it's something you would love to have just because you would love to have it and you don't even need a reason, that's a true choice. When the reason comes into play, what you can be making the choice from is trying to resolve and fix something that you believe is wrong in your life. So like an example would be like, I have no money, right? Or I don't have enough money, or I don't believe I have enough money. So I really just need to make a choice for money, because that's going to resolve everything. And my life will be better once I have the money. And maybe you've been on the side of the spectrum where you haven't had the money, and maybe you've been on the side of the spectrum where you have had the money. And has it really gotten better either way, right? Maybe for a little while, but what happens? After a while, the facade of the betterness, right, kind of fades away, and suddenly all those problems, right, just come back, right, that were there before. And so what we do in Recode is we don't avoid those things. We don't avoid, the patterns, the beliefs that are coming up, or what your current life experience is, your current reality. We actually place awareness on that. But what we do in Recode is we don't make that the focus. So we're not trying to fix that or resolve that or heal that part of us. We're just placing awareness on it. So we're not avoiding it either. So you know, this is a place that to be, that's a very safe container for you to be very vulnerable with anything that's going on in your life. And actually, the more that we can name it and the more that we can outwardly express it, that's where the resistance can go down, right? It can start to go down. We've given it some attention because that's what it wants, but we don't focus on it now. When we make it the focus, that's when we can start to downward spiral down that rabbit hole of all the limiting beliefs and negative thoughts and all that stuff, right? So we don't make it our focus, but we do place awareness on it. What we do make our focus, like I said, is we make that true choice together. You know, you're going to make one tonight. And then we focus on the end result. We focus on the end results of that choice, and we release and surrender of how we're going to get there, right? And you'll see at the end, when the resistance is down, the house starts to come, actually. And you'll get that clear next step, usually, about what's that next step to take to have what I would love in my life. And it just appears like magic when the resistance is down, because it's the resistance that's blocking it. So that's the process we're going to be going through tonight. And before we dive into it, I just wanted to share a bit about, you know, tuning into like the collective right now. It seems like there's a lot of like bouncing kind of crazy energy going on, where sometimes you feel like you're in all this possibility, and other times you just go to the total opposite of that and you feel like you're the you from like 5 or 10 years ago, and you're like, what is going on right now? Right. And so what I wanted to bring up is that these times, you know, where it can feel like more of a struggle, that's the most important time to stay in it, because that, those are the times we can say, you know, what I'm doing is not working. And maybe it's not because you didn't know you were in the problem structure, right? You're about to learn what, you know, what the creative structure is tonight. And maybe it wasn't working, right? But also, it's like, now that you're learning this creative structure, and I'm also going to teach you how you can stay consistent in being in that on a daily basis. You know, when you can be in that and just stay in that and be consistent, and it doesn't even take much time. I'm talking 5 minutes a day. I'm going to teach you something that you can do, that you can take home with you tonight. That is the thing. Even the 5 minutes, it's better than nothing, right? It keeps you in it. It keeps that consistency. And when we can stay consistent, we can move through stuff. And when you stay in the creative structure and keep your focus on this creative structure instead of the problem structure, basically what you start to notice is those problems and challenges start to naturally resolve themselves. Right? Like, you don't have to be the one that does it. Just kind of naturally, oh, that thing that was bothering me so much just isn't anymore, right? And so that's what we're going to be doing tonight. And I invite you to, you know, take home with you what you learned tonight and start using this on a daily basis, because it is super powerful. And drastic shifts can happen actually very fast. It's not always fast. You know, sometimes things happen very fast because you've had so much resistance about it around a certain thing, a certain area of your life for so long, that when that, even if that resistance goes down a little bit, it can cause a drastic shift in your life, because you don't realize how much it's actually blocking from coming in and you being that natural magnet that you are with your energy, right? So what we're gonna do tonight is really exciting. And I know you're all gonna experience some kind of shift tonight, because in my experience, it works every time. And that's what's so cool about it. So what I'd like to do as we get started here, we got a really awesome group here. We got 14 people, including me, which is amazing. What I'd like to do is just, if everybody can take a moment and just very short, we keep it to like a minute at the most. I want you to just kind of say like what brought you here, what called you here tonight, and if you're a repeater, you know, that's usually in the group. I want you to share, you know, what's the true choice you want to make tonight. And so I want everyone to share what true choice they're making tonight, because it's important to state that. So start thinking about that true choice. Remember, it's that thing you would love to have in your life for no other reason than you would love to have it. And most often it's that first thing that pops in your mind that you're like, no, it can't be that, right? You start to doubt it already. Like, oh, that's too big. How can I have that? That's the true choice. It's like that first thing that comes right there, right? So I'd like everyone to make a choice. And like I said, for the people who are here for the first time, just share, you know, what called you to come tonight. And I'll just start going down the list here. So first, Alex, if you could share. Go ahead and unmute.
I'm friends with Noah, and so Noah invited me. So that's what brings me here. He's what brings me here, and I trust him. The first thing that came up for me for the true choice question was the freedom to not respond to that question. And so it's really the, it's agency, sovereignty, it's,
yeah,
it's choice.
I like that, sovereignty. So you could make the choice of freedom and sovereignty if that resonates with you.
It doesn't. And it's something a little bit closer to permission, or no one's telling me what to do, which is different than freedom, you know, aliveness. Engagement, participation. So it's in that realm. So all of that.
Yeah, you know, say the words that light you up, that give you that feeling. And basically how you say it is, I choose the end result of, and then just insert those words right in there. Yeah.
I choose the end result of my heart's way, freedom, permission, and creative engagement in play.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Alex. Awesome. All right. Let's go. We're going to go to next we'll go to Casey. Go ahead and share. Go ahead and unmute and share.
So do you want this true choice? Is this a quality or whatever, as opposed to like, I want a new job or a new this or a new that?
It can be anything in any area of your life. Well, it can be like an area of your life, or a certain quality you'd like to call into your life.
I think I'm going to say love and fun.
Love and fun. Yeah. So say, I choose the end result of love and fun.
I choose the end result of love and fun, because I keep thinking that my outer world has to change for that to happen. But that doesn't matter. I just choose love and fun.
Yeah, you got it. That's why we're here tonight. Perfect. Thank you. Thanks so much, Casey. Okay. Let's go to Elizabeth. Go ahead and share. If you are there, Elizabeth. I see you're unmuted, but I can't hear you. Are you there? Yeah, I'm not here. Are you there, Elizabeth?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, there you are. Okay, yeah.
Okay, sorry. Tonight I choose the end result of forgiveness, from others to self and self to self.
Great. Thank you, Elizabeth. Okay, let's, Aaron, go ahead and share.
I choose the end result of being healthy, vibrant, and full of energy.
Yes, love it. Thank you, Aaron. Thanks for being here. And let's go to Johnny. Johnny, go ahead and share.
There we go. I came, Casey brought this up to me, so I showed up from by her recommendation. I choose the end result of playfulness, self-love, and forgiveness.
Great. Thank you so much, Johnny. Sure. Thanks for being here. Glad Casey invited you.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Yeah. Let's go to Catherine and George. Go ahead and unmute and share.
Hi. Well, you go first, George.
Sure. I choose the end result of vibrant health, happiness, and being a positive person.
Okay, I choose the end result of more joy, compassion, and freedom.
Awesome. Great choices all around. Thank you. Thank you both. Let's go to, I saw Katie put it in the chat. Katie, is your sound maybe not working? You can try.
No, I was just utilizing it to kind of help me remember what I was going to say.
Basically,
I choose the end result of joy. And then there was another little thing I wanted to add since y'all were adding. I was like, oh, I want to add on to joy. but I forgot. I'll add it when I remember.
Well, I see you. It says overflowing joy.
Yes, definitely.
Which I love that. Yeah. Yeah. If it comes to you, feel free to share it in the chat.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, Katie. And if anyone wants to put into the chat, you know, that's another way to ground this into reality. You've spoken it out now. If you want to ground it into reality, into the chat, you're welcome to do so. Let's go to Kay. Kay, go ahead, unmute and share.
I'm just about to put it in the chat. Okay, I think the end result of becoming super conscious creation, manifesting all things that are good for me.
It's a little hard to hear you, Kay, but I think you said a super conscious creator.
Yes.
Yeah, love it. That's awesome. That's a great choice. You. Thank you, Kay.
Thank you.
And welcome, Kay. Glad to have
you. Thank you. Yes, yeah. I'm a guest of Wanda.
Oh, cool. Very cool.
Yeah, thank you. I just said my schedule, my summer schedule allows me to come. So thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
Awesome. Yeah, my pleasure. Let's go to Noah. Go ahead and unmute and share.
I choose the end result of living my greatness and my purpose.
Awesome. Excellent choice. We have a lot of excellent choices tonight. Loving all the choices. Let's go to Russell.
Hi all, I'm here. Noah invited me this afternoon, and it was just great timing for me because tomorrow I'm taking the test for the Ciudadanía de México, which is Mexican citizenship. And so the result that I want is for it to be an easy, fun experience that goes smoothly and everybody's celebrating at the end.
That's really awesome and great choice. Thank you for being here. So glad you're here. All right. Thanks, Russell. Let's go to Scott. Go ahead and share.
Hopefully you can hear me because I'm driving.
Yeah.
I am choosing the final movement towards ever-increasing love and abundance in a myriad of forms and rapid healing for my hand.
Love it. Thank you. Thank you, Scott. I'm so happy you're here too. We got a great crew tonight, I have to say. Shule, go ahead and share.
Hi, everyone. I can't decide which one to choose. I wrote a few things. I choose the end result of enjoying the journey of life in vibrant health and energy.
I think that's an awesome choice. Yeah. It's making you smile, right? I think that's a good one.
I'll choose the other ones tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. You always got tomorrow. Thank you, Shule. And Shule actually brings up a good point, is that so sometimes people are concerned that they're making the wrong choice and they should make a different choice. And the cool thing about this work is that every area of your life is interconnected. And sometimes you'll choose in a specific area of your life, and it will also impact a completely unexpected area of your life in a way that you didn't see coming. So just be aware of that.
Can I add something to that?
Yeah.
In fact, whatever you're not fully focused on happens much quicker than the other ones. Because I remember the first time I was like, I choose the end result of health. You know, I was choosing that vibrant health. And then that week I got a new car, and like, I wasn't even choosing that yet, but it happened. It was like,
yeah.
And I was choosing to live in a nice house with nice friends and all that. And that took me like months, but it happened. So,
yeah.
Because I was really like wanting it so much that it creates a little bit of a friction, I think.
Yeah. And keeping that, you kept the focus, right, on the end result too, which led you there. And like I said, you know, some things will manifest really fast and others don't, and some unexpectedly, like a car, right? And it's like it can be illogical. Sometimes getting that car was part of your road to improve.
Better health.
Yeah. It's like, it seems illogical, but it's not always, right?
So, also, this is the best living situation I've had in 8 years that I've been in America. So like, I really focused on it and I knew what I didn't want, and it happened for me. So I'm really happy about it.
That's right. Yeah. Thank you, Shule. I'm happy for you too. Thanks for being here. And last but not least, we have Wanda. So Wanda, go ahead and unmute and share if you are there. I know sometimes Wanda has a little bit of trouble. So Wanda, if you're not unable to unmute, go ahead and put your choice in the chat and I will read it out loud for you to the group. Okay, so the next step is really getting into that end result. You've all made your true choices, which again, I wanna say how amazing your choices are. And now it's time to get into it, right? So how we get into it, we get into a state where we feel like we already have it, right? That's how we do it. Oh, and actually we got a little bit of a latecomer here. So let's see, we might have one more choice before we get into this. So I wanna give everybody an opportunity. So I see, I don't know if I'm saying this name right, but I think it's Tamananda. So Tamananda, what we were doing, we all just made true choices, and you can see some examples of that in the chat right now. There's some true choices there, like I choose the end result of fun and love and vibrant health and energy. So what we're all choosing is a choice that we would love to have for no other reason, right, than you would love to have it. So you make a true choice. And I've been inviting everyone to say that out loud right now, what your true choice is. And so if Tamananda, if you want to unmute and share, and you just say, I choose the end result of.
All right. Thank you for explaining that. I really appreciate it. I choose the end result of my natural talents being used in the highest service now.
Awesome. Love that choice. Thank you for being here. And did I say your name right?
Yeah, Tamananda. That's it.
All right. Really cool name. Thanks. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And I like the alchemistic. Very cool.
Yeah, that's my last name.
Oh, nice.
Thank you.
Yeah, so what we're going to do now is we're going to get into these end results and how we're going to do that. So I invite you to get comfortable. Just get in a comfortable position right now. And go ahead and close your eyes. And as you close your eyes, start by taking 3 deep breaths in your nose and out your mouth. Let your body start to relax. And I want you to see this spark. You can visualize, imagine this spark, or just feel, you know, this spark igniting in your heart center, right in the center of your chest. And let that spark start to expand through your body. That spark is your choice. The choice came right from that spark, because what you made today is a heart choice, is a true choice. And just let that feeling start to expand and start to feel like you already have your choice. Start to get into the emotions you feel when you already have that choice, and really feel that in your heart right now. I really want you to feel that in your heart. Start to amplify those emotions that are in your heart. And begin to amplify those. Expanding, starting to expand through your body. Let it expand up into your mind. You can even start to visualize what you look like. Imagine what you look like when you have this choice, you know? What are you doing? Who are you with? You know, you can see yourself smiling in the joy of having it. Could see it happening. And again, let those emotions come from already having it. And remember, your brain doesn't know the difference between imagination and a memory. It's all the same. So your brain thinks this is actually happening right now. So let those emotions expand, keep expanding, filling up your whole body, and let that feeling expand even more, going out, expanding outside of your body to your whole entire being. Yeah, just feel the lightness of that. Keep feeling those emotions. You already have it. You already have it. And when you are there, and as you see, it doesn't take that long to get there. When you are there, I want you to type into the chat, what are those specific emotions that you're feeling right now? When you already have it, and go ahead and name those and put it into the chat. I'm talking about emotions like joy, happiness, gratitude. You know, what are you feeling? A light. Can be anything. Typically, you know, it's a very positive emotion because it's something you truly want. I'm seeing peace, happiness, and tingling. Tingling is a new emotion they discovered recently. Love the tingling. I always feel tingling too. Energetic, yeah, vibrant, excited, joyful, gratitude, relief, ecstasy, profound peace, feeling gratitude and contentment, happy and optimistic, light and joyful. Awesome. Yeah, you know, when you're in that end result, you're in a high vibration, right? And so, like I was speaking earlier, when you can keep the focus on the end result, on this true choice, it keeps you in the high vibration, right? And it aligns you with it. And we're going to keep going through the process. This is part of it. So feeling like you already have it is part of it. And I want you to be able to, this is one thing you can take home with you too. Like if this choice you're making today is something you truly want, you know, keep making this choice every day and feel into it just like we just did. And even just a minute or two is enough. It's enough. You'll start being shown exactly how to get there, right? So, and it takes that consistency though. We want to be consistent all the time, and we want to really be in it, because it's all about being it in your life to see it in your life. And when you can feel like you already have it, well, you're being it. And the other part of it, you know, is saying how the law of attraction doesn't really take into the resistance into account the resistance that you might bump up against while going for this end result, going for this true choice. And there's always this discrepancy, right, between where you're currently at and what it is you're choosing, right? There's a discrepancy there. So what I want people to share now in the chat is, what is your current reality like compared to this choice you're making? What is it like now in your life, or how has it been recently, right? Is another way to put it. How has it been compared to the choice you just made? What's the discrepancy there? What's different about now than your choice? And I want you to share, you know, any emotions that are coming up. I want you to share, you know, your current life experience of what's really going on. And I want you to share any beliefs that might be coming up around this. And just go ahead and put that in the chat. And just know, I wanna share again that this is a safe container for you to do so. And you can be as vulnerable and honest, you know, as you can. And actually, the more vulnerable and honest you can be, it actually allows you to receive, you know, this end result that much quicker, right? So I see I have felt tired and have been experiencing pain, frustration, and having a hard time doing the things in life that I want to do. Yeah. Hard to get out of bed and do everyday things, feeling defeated, limited, stuck, oscillating. That's that back and forth I was talking about, the oscillation. I'm seeing, believe I'm not incapable, or that I'm incapable, I think it's supposed to say. Draining, overwhelmed, helpless, scared, struggle, toxic energy, unhappiness, suffering, despair, hopeless. Fake it till you make it is a lie. Yeah. Inertia, stagnancy, and confusion. Don't know what I should be doing. I'm seeing lots of anxiety, blocked, worried, depressed, and feeling like I'm going back to my fears I have suppressed. Frustrated and stressed about everything, no fun, no joy. Yeah, so, you know, as you're seeing, like, this is what everyone's sharing. So how often do we present ourselves to the world like everything's fine, right? We're not taking into account the discrepancy that's actually going on. We're not taking into the account the resistance. And when we can take into account the resistance, it's actually creating this proper tension. And tension, you know, it doesn't have to be a bad thing. Tension is what creates, helps create the end result. So we're creating this tension that instead, you know, this is your current reality, right? This is your past. Here's your current reality. Here's your future. The tension is now coming from here instead of trying to get from it all the way back here from your past, because you're expressing what your current reality is. So it closes the gap. Makes you that much closer, right? So that's what we're doing here. We're creating this tension that once we state it, once we express it, is now we keep the focus on the end result. And you'll see that it's easier to do that once we do the actual recode and the resistance is down. Like you can get here in more of a flow. Like it doesn't have to be so hard because you're not coming from the past, you're coming from the present, right? That makes sense. So I'm seeing in a great place emotionally, but feeling a certain amount of physical pain. Yeah. And I want to let the people know who are in physical pain, Superconscious Recode can definitely help with physical pain. I've had a few people that it has helped, including myself, and someone who had a really bad arthritis for 6 months, totally gone after actually 2 sessions. So things can happen. And it's one thing I've had a lot of low back pain in the past. And ever since I've been doing Recode, it's been like so, so, so much better than in the past, right? It doesn't drag me down like it used to. And it's vastly improved. And most days I don't even notice that anything's there. So what I want you to share next, and thank you everyone for being vulnerable and sharing, because this is the human experience. We all go through stuff. It doesn't mean it's wrong just because you're going through something. I'm seeing one last one, which is feeling grateful and blessed with beautiful souls around me, seeing contrasts at work as an indicator of what characteristics I'm letting go of within myself. Money is flowing exactly when I need it in the exact amount I need, and I'm feeling some physical pain. See, like, yeah, all these things can be going really great in the moment. Your current reality doesn't have to be negative. And then there's like, usually it can be going really great, you know, and there's this one thing, you know, I'm experiencing some pain, right? So it's just being honest about everything, right? So I'm seeing I'm in a positive space for the most part, but I need to be more confident in my superconscious creation power. Yeah. Yeah, you know, you can choose that. I couldn't hear you all of that, Kay, but you know, you can choose that. I choose the end result of being a confident superconscious creator, right? You can say it just like that. Yeah, thank you. Okay, so what I want everybody to do now, we're gonna actually dive into the recode soon. But what I want everybody to do first is I want you to say where your resistance is at, because resistance is an important part of this. And naming everything, right, is an important part. So basically, I want you to share in the chat on a scale from 1 to 10. 1 being like, it feels very easy, to have my choice. 10 is like, it feels impossible to have my choice. And 5, you know, is right in the middle. Like it doesn't feel easy. It actually feels kind of hard. So somewhere on a scale from 1 to 10, like how easy, 1 being the easiest, 10 being the, like, most impossible, where are you at as far as where your current reality is to this choice you're making and where you want to be? So I'm seeing a 6, a 7, a 7, yeah, 5, 10, an 8, a 6, a 3, yeah, we're all across the board here, a 3. So it doesn't matter where you are. This is so we can, you know, see where you're at before the recode as a measurement. And then after we do the recode, see where it's at, see where your resistance at is at after. And I will say I've never seen it not go down. So I already know. You may not know what's going to happen, but I already know what's going to happen. And I'm seeing another 7 and a 5. And then Meta said, I choose the end result of authentic creation of my course. Awesome. Very awesome. Yeah, so I will say it's always worked when you make a choice. There was one time where someone came to my group like this, and for some reason they didn't make a choice. They came late and they didn't make a choice. And they were like, the recode didn't do anything. And I was like, did you make a choice? And they said, no. So that was the one time. So it works when you make a choice, because you're the one setting that intention. You're the one with the free will. It's basically like when you choose the end result, you're asking for it. So you have to ask for it, for it to happen. And everyone here has chosen that end result, right? I'm not missing anyone? I don't think so. Cool. So before we go into this recode, I wanted to share another song with you. I'm feeling the music tonight and just want to help everyone get into, you know, that space of receiving, because this is all about you now. This is all about receiving. You've done your part. Now it's time to receive. So I want you to all drop in and receive this song right now. This is not one of my songs, and it's one of my favorite songs, I would say, of all time. It was coming to me strong that I needed to share this song with you tonight, so just take this in. I think you'll know it. Make sure this is on. Okay.
When I find myself times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she's standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. There won't be an end.
happy when the night is cloudy. There is still a light that shines on me. Shine until tomorrow, let it be. I wake up to the sound of music. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. Oh, let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Speaking words of wisdom. Let it be. Oh, let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. There will be an answer. Let it be.
All right. Thank you, everyone, for receiving that song from my heart to yours. What I would love you to do right now is, again, get into that relaxed, comfortable position. We're going to be going into the fun part, the Superconscious Recode now. And for those of you that are new, I want you to share, this process is a process that takes about 10 to 15 minutes. And what I'm going to do is say a series of commands. It may sound a little strange to you. It may not be used to what you're hearing, or, you know, what you're used to hearing or how people talk. And I just want you to be open, you know, with no expectation. And basically, yeah, you're just here to receive. And what I'm going to be doing is, we're all here. You know, I'm going to be working with the superconscious field here. And you can think of the superconscious field, for those of you that know Joe Dispenza's work, it's basically the quantum field. And it's that place where those limitless possibilities exist. And it's a place where, you know, all the wisdom of the entire universe is. And what's so cool about the superconscious is that the superconscious is the eternal part of us. It's this field surrounding us, and it's that eternal part of our mind, actually. It's the superconscious mind. And because it's eternal, the superconscious only knows experience. It's only here for experience. And that means the superconscious doesn't say, this is right, this is wrong, this is good, this is bad. You know, it just says, hey, let's have an experience, right? I'm here for it all. And why that's so cool is because the superconscious is so open to any experience, you can ask the superconscious to do very specific things. And what we do in this is, I'm asking the superconscious to treat very specific things that I'm getting from the field, right? So it's from our group field. I'm receiving it, and then I'm asking for it. The superconscious is showing me. And it's so powerful in a group because we're all connected in this field right now. And what's going to happen is the best for everyone, right? And so, yeah, so just like I said, be open. And you don't have to do anything. Just close your eyes right now. That's the only thing you do have to do, is close your eyes and receive. So go ahead and start by taking 3 deep breaths in your nose and out your mouth. And as you're taking those 3 deep breaths in your nose and out your mouth, I want you to think about your choice, that true choice you made today. Again, I want you to say that true choice. You can either say it out loud or in your mind right now. Either is fine. And let your body relax and receive all the gifts that your superconscious wants to give you today. And so go ahead and say, I give Michael permission to connect with my superconscious. Thank you. And superconscious, are you there? Superconscious, are all parts desiring treatment today? Superconscious, please treat all parts, all resistance, all fear. Please share with all parts and aspects that no parts will die. All knowledge, wisdom is retained. And that even if just a little bit can be treated today, that's enough. Please treat and do a massive change history and everything is needed. Thank you. In superconscious, do you see the metaphor of the river, the boulders in the river blocking the flow? The way that the water is meant to flow. Do you see and understand that metaphor? Superconscious, please create the perfect treatment plan today for everyone here and everyone watching the replay. Treating everything in the perfect order and in the perfect way. Thank you. Superconscious, please bring up all the resistance, all the fear, all the boulders into the active experience now, so that it all may be treated with the intention of more satisfaction and less pain. Thank you. Superconscious, please treat this belief that it's hard to enjoy life, that life's supposed to be sweet and it's just not sweet right now. Do you see that? Yeah. Superconscious, please treat all resistance and do a massive change history and everything is needed. Thank you. And superconscious, please especially treat the crown chakra. Treating that divine connection that happens through crown chakra. Treating everything in the perfect order and in the perfect way, the way that it's meant to be. And please treat all of the chakras of the body, both front and back. Please treat related meridian system and organs. Please treat all body systems, treating everything in the perfect order and in the perfect way and doing a massive change history and everything is needed. Thank you. And superconscious, please treat all family entanglements, all suffering contracts. Please treat all past, present, and future events. And please treat the original event. Going back, as many generations as needed, and treating that. Please also treat the DNA, treating everything in the perfect order and in the perfect way, doing a massive change history, and everything is needed. Thank you. And superconscious, do you see this experience of life that it's like I'm going, I almost get there, and right as I'm about to get there, I come right back to where I've always been? It's almost like going back to the past. Do you see that? Yeah. Superconscious, please treat and do a massive change history, and everything is needed. Thank you. And superconscious, do you see what's going on with the throat chakra? Speaking my truth, using my voice outwardly. Yeah. Superconscious, please treat that in the perfect order and in the perfect way and do a massive change history. Thank you. And superconscious, please treat all definitions causing resistance, definitions of myself, of others in the world. And please also treat all parts that may be causing resistance, parts and sub-personalities. And also please treat all secondary intentions. Thank you. And specifically treat the people pleaser. And also treat the secret keeper. See that? Yeah. Also treat the runner. And the inner child, the wounded child. Treating all resistance in the perfect order and in the perfect way and doing a massive change history and everything as needed. Thank you. Superconscious, if there is any remaining resistance, anything at all, anything that is willing to be treated today, please treat all resistance and do a massive change history and everything as needed, treating everything in the perfect order and in the perfect way. Thank you. Superconscious, please ground in all the memories we've touched on today, including memories 1, 2, and 3, superconscious, unconscious, and self-conscious. And connect them back to the matrix of the universe. Grounding in today's true choices and end results into reality now. And please treat for as long as needed, even after this group session is complete, and for everyone watching the replay. Thank you. Thank you. So I want you to stay there for a moment with your eyes closed. Let the treatment continue to set in and process. Just be with it for a moment, be present with the process. Notice what's going on in your body. Notice how your body maybe feels a little different than when we started. Notice any sensations. Notice how you maybe feel more relaxed, more at peace. Now I want you to visualize, imagine, and see that spark in your heart starting again, right in the center of your chest and your heart chakra. Feel that spark, see that spark igniting. See that spark turning into a sphere of white light. Let that sphere of white light expand rapidly at the speed of light, just totally encompassing your whole body, spreading out, expanding even more, totally encompassing your whole entire being. That white light is now about 9 feet outside of your body, this sphere of white light around your body. Experience how the sphere, your own superconscious field that starts from your heart, that electromagnetic field from your heart, expands all the way outside your body. It's now touching something even greater. It's touching the entire superconscious field of all the information, all the wisdom that ever was, is, and will be. And in this place, I want you to ask, now that this resistance is down, I want you to ask. This is getting that relationship with your own superconscious. Say, superconscious, what's the next obvious action for me to take to have my true choice, to have my end result? And let it come. May get the answer right away. You may not get any answer right now, and since you asked, the answer will come, whether it's today or tomorrow or later. It's going to come because you asked. So whenever you're ready, whenever you feel like everything's complete, I want you to open your eyes. See how everything looks. It looks a little different now. When you come back, I want you to go ahead and put in the chat, what's your resistance at now? So remember, it's that scale of 1 to 10. 1 being your choice is easy to have, 10 being the choice you made is impossible. Typically, like I said, really every time goes down. So I'm already seeing low numbers. I'm seeing a 1, 2, 3, a 2, a 4. A 1 for sure, yeah. A 2, a 1. Yeah, that's awesome. And I want you to know that, you know, there's no place you have to be. You don't have to be at a zero. Even if the resistance goes down a little bit, you have to think sometimes you've been carrying around this resistance your entire life and without even being aware of it. And even if it goes down a little, it's a lot, actually. And so I just want you to be aware, you know, over the next week, over the next few days, just when things come maybe a little unexpectedly, you know, some kind of mini miracle or major miracle can come in the form of what you chose today. Just be completely open, you know, with the super conscious stuff, because we are working in the realm of the eternal. You know, there's no timeline. There's no timeline. We make these choices and we surrender them. There's no like set timeline that they're gonna happen on. Sometimes they happen very fast, sometimes not. So just be open, just stay open to things you notice, you know, within yourself. Those of you that were in pain, notice what's going on with that, you know, the next few days, and notice other areas of your life, what maybe starts to open up. And yeah, I'm super grateful for you all being here. I want to share that once a month we do these rock and recodes with the music, and they're always free. You're welcome to come. It's the first Tuesday of every single month. We're going to continue to do these. And we also have a regular group that's going weekly. Like if you really enjoyed this experience and you want to become part of our Superconscious Recode group that does it weekly, you're welcome to join us and create some magic and miracles in your life, and you know, keep choosing. And what it's great, we get to do this together, and we get to be in this community, the superconscious community, doing it together, and we all get to take each other to our end results, right? We're all there to support each other, and I'm there, you know, supporting everyone. And so if you would like to join, I'm going to put it in the chat now. You can, it's basically $47 a month, and it gets you every week, and you get all the replays. So if you're interested, I just, I do that sometimes. I sent a direct message by accident. I thought I put it into the group chat. Let me see where the group chat option is. Oh, there we go. Here's the link. So it's $47 a month, and yeah, like I said, you can be in this every week with us, and we can rock the recode together. And then rock and recode is that free thing we're gonna have first Tuesday of every month, and that's always free. And then also I want to offer everyone as a gift for coming tonight. I also do one-on-one sessions with people if you're needing like some extra personal support. And I wanted to offer everyone, I'm putting this in the chat too, is a mini recode session. So basically I'm gonna give you a 30-minute session so you can experience a one-on-one recode for yourself and what that is like. And we'll go through a similar process, a little different. Going to take you through some deeper questions actually in this mini recode, so you can gain some of that self-awareness, because that but self-awareness, you know, especially from the current reality, is a major part of this. Because if we can gain the awareness of what we bump up against, of this resistance, of the patterns, and recode is a really great way to gain that awareness. I've seen it as an amazing awareness increaser. I've been doing this for a year and a half, and it's like I don't even know who I was before, like, because I didn't really know myself. And now I know myself really well. And yeah, so I invite you into that, into the group, and into taking me up on that free mini recode offer. Yeah, good question. It says 60 minutes, but it's actually 30 minutes. It's a 30-minute session. I just like leaving time, a little extra time in case we go over. And I have a session after. I like taking that gap. So it says 60, but it's 30. And basically 30, you know, we might tip that up to, you know, maybe about 45 minutes if you're lucky. So again, really grateful for you all coming here. And I really hope you got something out of tonight. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave you with, so there's one more practice we're going to do. We have about 10 more minutes. So I'm going to take you through this morning routine. This is something you can do every morning. It only takes 5 minutes. You'll see we're going to go through it in 5 minutes. And this is something, like I said, that you can take home with you. And you can use this every day. And the people I know, including myself, who use this have experienced amazing results from it. And actually, before we get into that, so what I want you to do is, you know, if you got clarity on what that next step is, like what that next obvious action to take is, make sure you write it down for yourself, because this is something that's important. This is your own superconscious telling you how to get there, right? This is like using your own intuition, and this is an important part of this work. So go ahead and write that down. And if you want to ground it in, put it into the chat too. If you're really excited about that next step, go for it. Say what that next step is you're going to take. And Aaron, yeah, you have a good night too. Thanks for being here. And so we're just going to go through this process that you can take home with you and start to do every day. It takes about 5 minutes, and then I'm going to close out with a song. And I want to express my gratitude one more time. There were so many new faces here tonight, and I'm really grateful for you all choosing to spend your night here. It's super awesome. Super conscious awesome, actually. So what I want you to do is go ahead and get comfortable again and close your eyes. And these are called the four core choices. And I'm going to put these into the chat as I say them for you too, so that you can take it home with you. And actually, anyone who wants to stay connected, and you know, I have an email list too. So if you want to stay connected and learn about whenever these rock and recodes are going on, just put your email into the chat and you'll stay in the loop about it. So this first choice that we make is, I choose the end result of living a life I love. So that's the first one. I'm putting that into the chat now. So living a life I love. So you say, I choose the end result of living a life I love. And go ahead, say that out loud and close your eyes and start to have that experience of already living that life you love. Feel what it feels like to already have that. You already have this life you love. Really feel it in your heart, mind. And start to see yourself again with that life you love, and feel it in your whole body, in your whole being, letting those emotions amplify and expand that feeling. Yeah. And each one, you only need to feel it for 30 minutes or 30 seconds to a minute. That's enough. That'll do it. The second one, second true choice, and you can just keep your eyes closed, is living my true nature and true purpose. So these are choices, you know, pretty much every human being wants. And so even making these choices is really powerful alone. You can create a lot of magic in your life. So go ahead and say, I choose the end result of living my true nature, true purpose. Feel that in your heart. Feel that in your mind. Again, start imagining yourself living your true nature and true purpose. Let that feeling expand to your whole body and your whole being. You're already living it. Remembering the more you can be it in your life, the more you're going to see it in your life. And this is how to be it every day. And the next one is vibrant health and vitality. So for those people who, you know, are experiencing any kind of health challenges at the moment, this is a really great one. So say, I choose the end result of vibrant health and vitality. Feel what it feels like to already have that. Your heart is always a great place to start expanding that feeling. So feel it in your heart. Expand it out to your whole body. Start feeling that vibrant, healthy body that you already have. Yeah. And let it expand even more out to your whole being. You're just totally generating this from the inside out. And the next choice is being the creator of my reality. This is really stepping into that being that super conscious creator. So go ahead and say, I choose the end result of being the creator of my reality. Again, feel what it feels like to already have that. This means whatever comes your way, all the challenges, circumstances, still have a choice, and you get to create your reality, meaning you get to choose how you're going to respond and react to it all. Right? Just feel how good it feels to have that. Feel it in your whole heart, your whole body, your whole being. This is what it feels like to be a super conscious creator. So those are the four choices, and the last choice you're going to make, and you can do this, like I said, every day. In the morning it's best because it just gets you in that vibration first thing. So go ahead and say, what I want you to do is say the choice that you made today. So this is that choice, this true choice you made today. Say, I choose the end result of, and insert your choice. Remember, you've been divinely guided by your heart to make this choice today. So let that feeling start to expand in your heart. You already have it. Expanding to your whole body, your whole being. Just really feel what it feels like to already have that. See yourself having it. Imagine it. Attract it. Just feel how light it feels to be having this experience when the resistance is down. How amazing is it? So that's what you can take home with you. You can do that every single day. Put all the choices in the chat for you. Also, if you give me your email, I'll give you, I'll lay out that whole practice and exactly how to do it. So I'll keep you updated on these rock and recodes and any other cool stuff going on. And And I'll send you these four chord choices. And I also have a recorded meditation of it. So I'll send you the recorded meditation. You put your email into the chat right now. And I'm actually going to put my phone number. Here's my phone number in the chat. You can contact me about anything, any questions. Here's my phone number. And also, I'm going to put my email in the chat for you to have, so you can contact me anytime. I'm available for you. This is, like I said, this is one of my greatest passions, so I love to share it, you know, any chance that I get. And before I go into the song, just want to remind you one more time, take advantage of that free session, free 30-minute session. Book it. Take advantage of it. See what the one-on-one experience is like. It's going to be personalized just for you. And also, if you're, you know, feeling called to be in this group, there's the link in the chat as well. And again, it's $47 a month. Okay. Well, love you all. And I'm going to share one more song with you. This is the Superconscious theme song that I wrote a few months back. And there's actually a recorded version of this as well, which now I'm like, well, I guess I need to share that with you too. This is a time for sharing. So I'm going to share you the song to inspire you. You know, one of my greatest visions is to help ignite this superconscious revolution around the world. You know, and it's starting here in this group. You start somewhere and then it just keeps expanding, you know? So that's one of my greatest visions. And the song to, you know, ignite that superconscious revolution and really inspire a lot of people to get into this creative structure and creating this life they love and living their true nature and purpose. And think about a world filled with that, people like you, right? This is what we're creating here. So here's the song. Enjoy the song.
Strictly all the schools.
What's up?
Okay, so let's see. I got it.
Oops, we lost you, Kay. Did you have a question? Yeah, if anyone has a question.
Adventure, right?
No, no question. It was an accident. Thank you.
Okay, cool. So here comes the live version of the Superconscious song for you. And just again, I invite you to take this in and receive this song from my heart to yours. Nothing. Oh, wait, we don't have the musician's sound on. That's a key. Okay. Redo. There's nothing to fix, no solution to find. You're not broken and you're not alone. You have a choice to make. Look through the lenses of time. You can be it to see it in your life. I know you think you don't belong, and the evidence has shown you're not good enough, you're still looking for your home. I know you think you're worthless, less than perfect, insignificant at best. So let go and let your soul do the rest. Be super conscious. Stay focused on what you want. With your end result in mind, you can be your true self, a creator of your wealth. You get to decide what success is, how you love and how you live it.
how you give it and how you shine. I know you think you're worthless, less than perfect, insignificant at best. So live your purpose, let your spirit do the rest. Be super conscious.
Thank you, everyone. Take care. Have a wonderful night.